Welcome to an example on how to use the newer version of the TI84 to determine the probability that a z-score is between two given z-scores for the standard normal distribution. Here we're asked to find the probability that z is greater than -1.25 and less than 0.92. So looking at the graph of the standard normal distribution shown here below, z equals -1.25 would be approximately here. And z equals 0.92 would be approximately here. The area under the curve between these two z-scores is the same as the probability that z is greater than -1.25 and less than 0.92. So we'll use the TI84 graphing calculator in order to determine this area, which is the same as the probability that we're looking for. We'll be using the normal CDF feature on the TI84 in order to find this area and the probability. So after we select the normal CDF feature, we'll have to enter A, B, mu, and sigma. Remember, mu is the mean and sigma is a standard deviation. So this feature gives values for the cumulative normal density function occurring between x equals A and x equals B. And this would also be the cumulative area under the standard normal distribution between A and B. But if we set mu equal to 0 and sigma equal to 1, then A and B will be the upper and lower bound z-scores. So notice in this case, the lower bound z-score is -1.25 and the upper bound z-score is 0.92. So from the home screen, we press second vars for distribution. We want to select option 2 for normal CDF, which brings us to this screen, which we don't see on the older version of the 84 or the 83. Again, because we're going to let mu equal 0 and sigma equal 1, well, remember mu is the mean and sigma is a standard deviation, the lower bound and upper bound values are going to be z-scores. So our lower bound is -1.25, enter. The upper bound is 0.92. And since mu and sigma are already 0 and 1, we'll press enter down to paste. And when the cursor is on paste, we press enter, and it copies all the information we just entered to the home screen. If we scroll to the far left, notice how we have normal CDF, and then we have the lower bound z-score, upper bound z-score, mu, the mean, followed by the standard deviation, or sigma. So if we press enter, this gives us the area of the shaded region, which is also the probability that z is greater than -1.25 and less than 0.92. So as a decimal, the probability is approximately 0.7156. Or as a percentage, we'd have approximately 71.56%. I hope you found this helpful.